Hey guys, this is me again. Today, as I told you in an earlier video, I went to a coin fair. There's one in my neighborhood, not my town, but a town nearby. And it has a fair, I think, two times a year over there. Always try to attend it, but in the springtime I could not make it, so I went now. I collect a lot of coins from different countries. I like especially the older silver coins, pre-1950. I try to collect coins from 1850 until 1950, and I see it as a small investment for the future. This is the organization, MPO. It says Munten Postzegel Organisatie, so it's like the coin and stamp organization. This is the program. If you subscribe to them, you get a free ticket two times a year, so I make advantage of it. Otherwise it's a €2 entry fee. There's one dealer, he sells a lot of stuff for the collectors, like these. These cost in the shop in a 10 pack €6.90 for so it's 69 cents for each one. And I bought 50 of those and these coin holders, and that together was €52.50. And if you have to buy only this, so 5 times almost €7, it's already 35. And then this is I thought they're packed by 50 50, and they sell around €6 a piece, I think. So that's 54 euros only for this. So I have €2 in my pocket, and that I have for free. So that's why I go to that big seller. He buys in bulk, and I buy in bulk from him. From one guy I bought this. These are coins from 5 guilder before the euro. It's not some kind of precious metal, but as you can see, there two are UNC, so that's uncirculated coin, so it's worth more than a coin that was in the hands of a lot of people. I was missing these years. I paid €7.50 for it together, and I got a nice envelope with it, so I'm gonna keep that envelope. It's good when you go to a flea market and stuff, you have a precious coin, you can put it in. I was talking with a guy, and my girlfriend also, she attended, and I liked it a lot, because she, just to show some interest, I tried to educate her also on this, on the matter. The guy was telling a lot about the silver, and he also thinks that the economy will be in a big turmoil, and that the coins and paper money will not be worth a lot of money. So he was also selling a lot of silver. I bought this one. It's 10 grams of fine silver, 999.0 purity, so it's silver in its most purest form. It's from the Union Bank of Switzerland. It's 10 grams. Paid €12.95 for it. It's the first one I have like this, but I like it. I have a few Kookaburra coins from Australia. That's 1 ounce of fine silver, and this is 10 grams. I like it. I'm gonna keep it, and I think in the future I will buy some more. It's something if you need a lot of money, you can get quick cash money for this. And even if the price will go down, this will be worth money, and the coins will not be so. Then I went also to appraise a couple of coins. As you can remember, I bought these three over the internet. They also did a free taxation. This one and this one I paid like €10 a piece. They are worth €10 a piece. This one is an old coin from 1545 till 1608. I paid around €10 for this one also, and it was worth over €20, so say it's worth like 25, so that's an €18 profit over only 3 coins. And then I bought this from Iraq. 10 fills, 1938, 10 fills, 1959, 1981 with a nice palm tree, 50 fills, 1981, 5 fills, 67, 250 fills, 1980, also with a palm, 1938. Got some East German coins, 1950, was missing that year. It's 10 cents, 10 pfennig. One Deutschmark from 1956. Two silver coins. It's a two Reichsmark coin from 1939 with von Hindenburg. And a half mark, so it's a 50 cent coin from Germany from 1906, also silver. Then I got German coins here, Austrian coins. Try to get a little bit more of that. 1947, 10 cents, a shilling from 1962. 1971, I just picked up everything that was cheap and I knew I didn't have. 1972, 73, 74, 1960, 1959. This is old Germany. 50 cents, some kind of aluminum coin, 1922, 1 cent, 1924, 1927, also all very cheap, didn't have those years. 1879, 1 cent. 1896, 1911, 1907, 10 cents. 1904, 1 cent. 1904, 2 cents. This is 10 cents from 1919, didn't have that one. 1 cent 1925 with a nice wheat, I don't know what you call it in English, but when you harvest the wheat. 1909, 1 cent. 1917, 5 cents. 1916, 2 cents. 1915, 5 cents. And 1905, 2 cents. So it was just a little pile. Normally I buy a little bit more, but I was aiming for this and this because of the 10 kilo box I've showed you earlier. I was running out of these, so I had to buy it, and I have to wait. I waited about 3 weeks until the fair was there, and I scooped them up for cheaper than retail. And also some small coins, they are not going for big money on the internet, plus you have to pay shipping. I have to go to the fair for this stuff, so I picked these up for cheap. And I had an evaluation of the three coins. It was my first time, and I was pretty scoped that it brought an 18 euro profit already. So I'm gonna keep it for my retirement fund, as I like to call it. I like these three coins. I got a free advice from the guy, and I got a small silver bar. So okay guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and stay tuned for my next coming video in the next weekend probably. Bye bye.